Okay, so next here. After that, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I would like to express my heartfelt welcome. Thank you for coming to Denver. This is such a pleasure. My colleagues in New York just saw you on Friday. I've worked with Robbie Barnett before. I've been on the Tibet program. My name is Nicole Willock, and I'm a new professor at DU, and I do Tibetan studies. I was formerly at Indiana University, and I've studied in China, and I've been to the China Tibetology Center. I went to the bookstore and bought a whole bunch of books there. So it's an amazing place. So thank you very much. One of the things I wanted to ask is, it's an international studies question, but it's also a local question. And the legacy of one of the great Tibetologists, Eugene Smith, is the Tibetan Buddhist Resource Center, which is an online collection of probably the best Tibetology books in the world. And Sichuan Research Institute has just recently acquired those actual books, and I was wondering what sort of access is made to Tibetans, with Tibetan, young Tibetan scholars, you know, perhaps this generation's age, to access those books, and if there's a kind of active promotion of that material going on within China itself. Yeah.
非常感谢你们来到这里。其实哦，你们我知道你们周五的时候在纽约是和我的同事见面的。我和罗伯特巴列特教授是同事，我叫Nicole。然后我现在是成为了丹佛大学的一名教授，之前是在印第安纳大学。我本人曾经去过中国藏研中心，也在张学出版社买了很多的书。我的问题是，既是一个国际关系的问题，也是算是一个地方的问题，就是James Smith先生，他成立的这个西藏之前那个博物馆，那个委员会。那么那个中心那里有，基本上他对于藏学的藏书是最多的。那么最近四川的研究机构得到了，就可以得到了这些使用这些资源的渠道。那我想问一下，如果能再国内有没有做一些推广，能够让更多的年轻的藏学的研究藏学专家来能够看到这些材料？谢谢。
很高兴您去过藏学研究中心，而且还买了我出版社的很多很多的书，我很高兴。那么这个金·史密斯先生在世的时候，我们跟他都有过很多的交流和交往。他的那个在纽约的那个就是藏文的那个中心，我自己也去过不止一次。
First of all, thank you very much for being in TBRC and buying many of our books. When Mr. James Smith was still alive, we have frequent exchanges and contacts with him. And I personally have been to the TBRC more than once in New York.
那个James Smith他的那个很多藏书后来都捐给了国内的四川的西南民族大学，这个事情其实我自己还是感觉到有点遗憾。本来我们也跟他做过一些个这个商谈嘛，希望能 给我们也捐一部分，但后来因为有一位这个活佛，土登尼玛先生在他那地方做研究做了很长时间，所以土登尼玛先生又是在四川来的，所以就把书捐给了四川，有这么一件事情。那么这个他所做的那个藏文的这种输入啊，把它数字化这个事情。 我觉得非常好，而且就是我出版社有一个叫巴多的一位先生，就在那儿跟他已经合作，帮助他一起搞这个工作，搞了很多年了。Mr.
Jin Smith donated many of his collection to a university in Sichuan. We feel a little bit pity because we actually hope that he could donate some of his collection to the TBRC. But because of one living Buddha, is Mr. Tudanima had been working closely with him, and the living Buddha himself was from Sichuan province, so he donated them to Sichuan. And actually, they are in TBRC, they are digitalizing these books. And one of my colleagues, he's called Mr. Baduo, is helping with the staffs at TBRC, and he has been working there for many years.
那么刚才讲到的，他已经这个录入的那些电子版的这个藏文的古籍啊，和现代的一些书籍，包括我们出版社的一些书，他都录入了，应该是一件非常好的事儿。因为现代化的这个手段，电子出版物的这样的一些个使用的方便。 可能对这个青年人学习藏文化呀和这个使用这个藏文更有利，我对这件事情是非常的这个看好的。
It is very good to see that they have digitalized many publications, including some of ours. And I think that the e-copies of these books actually help facilitate young people to have a better understanding of Tibetan culture. Personally, I think this is very good.
藏学研究中心的图书馆他们也在做一些相关的项目，包括跟那个西藏自治区的这个西藏大学、西藏社科院的合作，把他们的一些个这个旧公文，就是原来藏政府的一些旧公文，还有一些古籍，也进行整理电子化，实际上目的是相同的。
The library of this TBRC, China Tibetology CTRC, is also working in collaboration with the Tibet Autonomous Regional Government, the Tibet University, and the Tibet Academy of Social Sciences.To compile and edit and publish the documents from the old regime of Tibet.